Will flying cars actually go commercial in 2026? Here to talk about what's happening in the eVTOL industry this year is MarketBeat analyst Jeffrey Neal Johnson. Jeffrey, I know this is one of your favorite topics. I'm really excited to dive into this list today. We're going to talk about the two leaders that everybody talks about, but know that the list of eVTOL players around the globe is really growing. So we're going to cover a total of 6 eVTOL companies today in this video. All right, Jeffrey, let's get to that first name on the list. This is the leader, and it is also seeing quite an increase in its stock price just this week.
Yeah. So the first one on our list is Joby, and it's up about 20% this week. The entire sector is climbing up this week. You know, we had tax loss harvesting at the end of December, and then we had this kind of rotation across all sectors. I've talked about it with you in other videos where all of these speculative sectors, you've got AI, you've got eVTOL, you've got quantum, they're all going to this, if you can't show me how it's going to make money, then we don't really want to put our money into it kind of phase. The thing about it is that now that they're moving into this show me phase, you have the leaders in the sector starting to show their strengths. So with Joby, you know, they're nearing the end of their completion of their certification. They received their first shipment of FAA certified simulator. So the only way to train pilots is through a simulator. And now that they have their FAA certified simulators, they can start training pilots well ahead of their Dubai launch later this year.
And that's the main question I have about Joby. The question every investor has in the whole eVTOL sector is, when are these things actually going to go commercial? We want to see that proof that you're talking about. And that proof is, will there be commercial demand for the products that they are working on and have been working to build for the last few years? So let's talk about commercialization for Joby. How close is that and how real is that in 2026?
2026 seems to be the year for a lot of these players for slated commercialization. Joby has a 6-year contract in Dubai. So as soon as they can get certified and they can ship their first ones over to Dubai, they're flying. All of these are very close, and it seems like 2026 is going to be the year.
I know many investors are excited to see that happen. I know that also means a big year for battery companies. Batteries play a big role in a lot of these eVTOL vehicles. And so if you're looking at some battery stocks to invest in alongside eVTOLs, make sure to check out this report. It's a list of 5 lithium and battery stocks to watch in the new year. You can scan the QR code or click the link in the description to get that free list of 5 stocks right now on MarketBeat.com. All right, Jeffrey, let's go from Joby to the next major player. We all know it's Archer. Is this still a neck and neck race between the two of them, or is Archer kind of falling behind?
You know, Archer and Joby, they are pretty much neck and neck. It seems like just as fast as one releases news, the next one releases news. But Archer is very fast. They're very capital efficient. And so they're already building their factories, right? So they've got this factory in Georgia that's about to come online. And I think that they're basically also just waiting for certification. You've got the contract with Joby in Dubai. You know, you've got a contract with Archer in United Airlines. So just as fast as they can get their certification going, they can immediately start building their aircraft and pumping them out for United. And of course, that building and the certification of the building of their plant in Georgia is being handled by Stellantis. So they've got a hardcore backer that's helping push them along the way. And again, it will not be long for them before they're out there carrying United Airlines passengers to and from Chicago.
Yeah, this stock also seen a nice bump this week with a renewed investment coming to kind of trading right alongside the increase in what Joby's seeing right now. I think one thing when you're talking about the partners, having Joby have Toyota as a partner, but also seeing that there's airlines also coming to partner with his eVTOLs, it makes me wonder, is flying cars the right word? Are these aircraft? Are these cars? Will this actually become the sci-fi version of the flying cars that people think of? Or is this just going to be an extension of air travel in the U.S.? What do you see it launching as in 2026?
I think in 2026, it's just going to be the commercialization of the current aerospace sector. So you're talking about flying cargo. You're talking about medical evac. You're talking about maybe emergency evac, like rescuing people off the top of buildings, that kind of stuff. We aren't at the Jetsons moment yet, but you have a lot of companies out there that, you know, some of them aren't on the market, like Jetson One, that are making smaller versions of these eVTOLs, which will be essentially flying cars. I mean, if you look at what Archer is building, it's more like a flying minivan than a car, but in the future, you can see one of those being as accessible as going to your local convenience store or grocery store, and there's one parked there, and you swipe your phone, you tell it where you want to go, jump in, it takes you there. That's the goal. So we will have the Jetsons moment, and I think that the people that are currently single-engine pilots and are flying as a hobby will take a deep interest into these, especially as they become commercially available once you can actually buy one.
So the fully commercialized Jetsons version, as you said, of those flying cars, not going to happen in 2026, but the start of the sector and this industry actually going somewhat commercial, like you said, more like airline cargo commercial, is coming in 2026. You have four other players to talk about in this eVTOL race that are also already gaining some traction across the globe. But I want to talk a little bit more about what you expect for both Archer and Joby stock this year. Again, January starting off with a big jump for both of these companies. Do you see just an upward climb ahead? Do you see more volatility ahead this year? What do you see happening for these two leaders this year?
I see both of them. I see the entire sector as a growth sector, because last year it was a lot of, you know, will it work? Won't it work? Short reports saying that maybe they can transition, maybe they can't transition. And a lot of that has already been blown through. Now they've proven they can transition. They've proven that the physics works. They've proven that all they got to do is get this thing certified, and they've already got people waiting to fly in it. They've already got people waiting to haul cargo in it. So you think about that and you start looking at other aerospace sector players. Like, imagine if Boeing or if Airbus was pre-revenue. Right now, Boeing and Airbus, pre-revenue. And then look at maybe, say, 10 years from now, and look at where Boeing and Airbus is right now.
I think that's a good way to look at these companies, but you're definitely in that statement you gave. You're not talking about this year. You're still looking at these as a 10-year investment. So investors out there, don't expect to see major massive gains in just 1 year with the commercialization launching, especially in Dubai. Still a 10-year long-off project investment if you're looking at it, right?
I would agree with that, but you also have to consider, how long would it take a stock to go from $10 to $200? That doesn't happen overnight if it's a fundamentally sound and a fundamentally healthy stock. So I would anticipate that from now to commercialization being extremely volatile, and then after commercialization being just this steady, healthy growth.
Now, this is not just a Joby versus Archer video. There are other names and other players in the story. We still have four stocks to get to. And this next one is one that you are personally very excited about. Let's get to this other company that maybe a lot of investors haven't really heard of much.
My next company is Vertical. And you're right. I'm actually very optimistic about this company. They have a lot of things that the other two don't have, and they don't have a lot of things that the other two have. Both the have and the don't have create a positive scenario for the stock. Not a lot of people know about them, and they don't get the push in the United States that Joby and Archer get, but that's about to change, because they've committed to, by the end of January, sometime in this first quarter, they're coming to New York, they're bringing the craft to New York, and they're coming specifically to show it off to institutional investors. When they bring this craft over, they're going to be showing a direct competitor to Joby and Archer. They're a little bit further behind, so they're in like stage three of their certification, which is where they have not completed the transition flight. So Joby and Archer can take off and they can land, and they can take off and transition to a forward flight, and they've already proven they can do that. Of course, Vertical claims that they can do the same. They just haven't proven it yet. And that proof is coming in this quarter. So when that proof comes, I think that the institutional investors are going to see this thing and they're going to go crazy, because the craft is 50% bigger. It can carry two more people than Joby and Archer. And at the same time that it's carrying two more people, it can also carry more luggage than Joby and Archer's craft can carry. So you have this basically unseen direct competitor that very few people know about, that is about to possibly take the U.S. market by storm, because the big thing about their business strategy is, unlike Joby and Archer, They're not trying to rule the world. They don't have a sugar daddy like Toyota or Stellantis. They're doing it on their own. So just the other day, they had to come out and say that they need to raise capital. Of course they need to raise capital. They can't call their automotive partner and say, I need more money or we can't build this thing. So they're going to raise capital, and this ask to raise capital is kind of being seen by the market as a negative because I don't think they're paying attention to the full story. So you have all of these perceived negatives that are building up for the company, but these perceived negatives are actually hardcore positives when they switch from the developmental phase to the commercialization phase.
Assuming all goes well, that's one of the main caveats when you're looking at any kind of speculative play like this, is you need to also be prepared for the risk factor because it is still in development. This is a UK-based company, right?
Correct.
This company, yes, based in the UK, again, doesn't have the large backers, maybe not a name that you've heard of as much around the country, but you're very bullish on this, and analysts seem to be too. It's also is the stock itself is growing, not the 20% that Joby and Archer have seen this week, but up almost 12%. Are analysts as bullish on this one? Is it getting any analyst attention yet?
So analysts are bullish on this. It's not getting the analyst attention that it deserves. And I think that that will change after their New York debut. I think that the analysts have just kind of said, it's either going to be Archer or it's going to be Joby. I don't think that they understand what a dark horse that vertical aerospace could be for the market. I think that vertical strategy of just selling the aircraft directly to the airlines, to a regional airline, it could be United, it could be any airline, selling it directly to them, selling the replacement batteries, selling the parts, et cetera. It's the same strategy that Boeing uses to sell their plane. Boeing doesn't have this massive vertiport infrastructure, and they're not trying to rule the world. They just build planes, and they build really good planes. That's kind of what vertical's doing. They want to put the planes out there. They want to be known for safety. They want to make their margins off of the batteries and the replacement parts that need to go on the plane. And that strategy might be one of the fastest go-to-market strategies for the entire sector.
I think that's a really interesting point about this company, is that they're using more of the Boeing business model than the starting a whole new industry and sector from scratch model that we've talked about with Joby and Archer. So very interesting. It's also why I'm choosing to add this one to my Bridges Buys watch list for this video. Again, we're covering six names today, but this one, it's a risk for sure. I am considering this a very high risk speculative play. Lack of cash is concerning for sure. So I'm adding it with hopes that they're able to pull it off in the future, because I like the business model that you're talking about and the fact that it's a lesser known stock and it doesn't have as much investor excitement yet. So I'm hoping that it's a get in early kind of buy to add to my paper trading watch list, but it is a risk. And I know that it could definitely end up going the other direction too. So that's something to keep in mind with any of the ones we're talking about today. Let's get from your favorite one that we just talked about to three other names, some of which are already in the sky, it sounds like, in a different part of the world.
The next one we're going to talk about is a brand new entrant. They IPO'd in November. They're called Beta. They have taken a different route. So they're dual certifying a conventional aircraft called the CX-300. And then they're going to, once that aircraft is certified, they're going to get their vertical takeoff and landing craft, the A250. Certified second. So they've certified the CX-300 first, and then they're going to utilize that airframe. They're going to utilize that technology to then certify their vertical takeoff and landing. Big difference in their strategy is that they are going for cargo first, and that changes the certification path because you don't have to worry about flying other people around. And so it's an easier certification path for them and allows them to book hours into the airframe so that when they transition to flying passengers, it's an easier transition. So they IPO'd about 3 months ago, and the market absolutely loved this cargo only play. The stock climbed $28.88 as of today. And it's been kind of hanging out there. They raised about $1 billion from this, creating a really nice runway to get them at least through the phases of certification to get the cargo side of things done. And I think that getting to the market fast and building your brand is going to be a big thing. And with Joby, Archer, and Vertical so far ahead, for Beta to come in and just change the play and say, we don't want to haul passengers, we only want to haul cargo, I think that it actually gives them a faster way to commercialization. That and $1 billion in their pocket. You know, $1 billion in your pocket can buy a lot of speed.
And is this an American company?
They are an American company. And, you know, since you asked about that, one of the things that differentiates them is the fact that they are discussing the building of a supercharger network for planes. So similar to Tesla's supercharger network, it diversifies them from just building the plane to also being able to charge for the charging. And I think that that's a good play for them. So yeah, they are US based. They are diversifying in such a way that I think that they could also be a really strong contender globally.
Interesting. Another name we haven't really heard about in the eVTOL conversation. Let's get to the other two companies that you have on this list.
Okay, so the other two are not US-based, since you asked about it. The next one is going to be Eve Air Mobility. The thing about Eve Air Mobility is they are just starting, just like Beta, but just like Joby and Archer, they have a sugar daddy. They've got Embraer. And Embraer jets spun them off and set them up to start developing the prototype. It's unnamed. They've got their unnamed prototype developed, and it's not far from the start of testing. They've got the backing of Embraer jets. And so you have to assume that once they're up and flying, they also have the Embraer jet client list that they can utilize to start selling these things.
Again, it's one of those emerging markets too, getting outside of the US markets and looking at something a little bit different. Let's get to that last company on the list. This is really the only one that's actually already commercially launched.
Correct. And that's Ehang, and they're out of China. They're commercially launched, but the caveat is that you would have to assume that they had a highly lubricated path to commercialization. They're already flying people in China, and they're already flying cargo in China. And so it's a proof positive to the fact that if it works in China and they're able to do it, the business model could directly translate to the United States and to other places. They're already looking to reach out into the UAE and put their aircraft out there. But of course, Joby has that on lockdown at this time. So the Chinese counterpart to this sector starts looking for global commercialization. They're going to have to start adhering to the global safety standard, which means that this certification that they have in China may or may not hold up. And that's the speculative part of that stock. They could run into regulatory headwinds when they try to take this to, say, for instance, the UK, which is very stringent.
Well, some different names for investors to consider. If you want another video with a more in-depth look at just Joby versus Archer Aviation, make sure to watch this video too.